Hey guys, I am recording this, so hopefully I can start putting out content on my YouTube page, so stay tuned for that. Right here I have got a gessoed black canvas. I have coated it with a thin coat of oil, the clear oil, and just making sure that I don't have too much. So when you put the oil on, always wipe it off, and whatever's left is what you're gonna need. So I'm hopefully doing these videos to help people realize that you don't need to be a trained artist to be able to paint. It is so easy and it is so relaxing. It's actually really addictive. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a little waterfall scene. So I'm going to put some transparent colors on, my canvas so that then I can kind of bring out the colors as I go. So let me see. The first, color that I'm going to go in with is going to be phthalo blue, kind of like right here in the sky, where the waterfall is going to be and where the water is going to be. And I think I'm going to do some sap green or phthalo green on the outside. So yeah, we'll see. I kind of have a thing in my head of what I want, but I'm not really sure. So let's just get into this. All right. So I'm just putting a little bit of the phthalo blue on my brush, and we're just going to put it kind of where I want my sky to be. And this just really gives a nice look. When you're first putting the colors on, like, you basically don't even know that you're putting any colors on. That's when you know that they're truly transparent. So let's see. Okay, I know I want my waterfall coming down in through here. So we're gonna bring that blue down. And we're gonna put it all over the bottom of the canvas, because that's gonna be our, like, our water splash. So I'll probably do just blue on the whole bottom half here. Kind of something like that. All right, so I'm going to take another brush and we're going to just put, let's see if I find another brush. All right, and then I'm going to put, you know what? I'm just going to put blue on the whole thing. And then we're going to use the yellow to bring out the green. Yeah, changed my mind midstream. So yeah, basically we're going to just coat the whole canvas with the phthalo blue. All right. So I'm just going to wipe the excess off, and now I'm going to go in to my white, and I'm going to start defining where I want my sky to be. I'm going to actually switch to my 1-inch brush, and I'm going to put some white, which I forgot to put on my palette. All right, so let's, and you only need a little bit of the white, because once we start putting it on, that's going to be really, really powerful. So let's kind of, oh yeah, that's a pretty blue. So I'm gonna want some peekaboos going through my trees. All right, and then we're gonna make a little bit lighter area. So I'm just gonna add a little bit more white. Just so we can have some nice white light popping through. A little bit more. All right. So we're going to go back to our big 2-inch brush, and I'm going to pick up some yellow. Now, I've never tried this combination, so hey, I don't know what's going to happen. Oh. All right, so I finally got a setup so that I can make videos, but now I gotta get my lighting right because I can't see. Oh yeah, that is gorgeous. And all right, let's get a little bit more. And you notice I'm leaving some of the dark behind it. That's gonna give the depth. All right. Oh, I'm liking that. And then we can add a little bit more highlights as we go. Let me see. So in through here, I'm gonna want like some pine trees. So I am going to use a this is a number 15 filbert brush. And let me see, I'm going to just go in with, I'm going to try a little bit of sap green. This brush might be a little too big. We'll see. We'll see. All right. So let's see. I'm going to stand up because I got a wicked glare. Because I want these to still be kind of off in the distance. So we don't want them with too much detail. I just want some indications of something back there. I'll switch to a smaller. Well, let me try a fan brush. Put these type of trees in. I think we might need a fan brush. All right, so let me just load that up. I think the fan brush is making them a little bit better. I'm gonna want this. I had them too much going the same height, so let's. One right there. All right, now just pull out a little bit of landmass. Go across there. And let's see. All right, so I want my waterfall coming this way. So I'm going to wash this brush. And let's see. I'm going to pick up some white. And I'm going to start just putting in. Let's see. Where do I want my waterfall? Because then I'm going to have some. Some water in right here. And let's see, we're gonna. All right. So we're gonna have some trees or something here. We're gonna have the waterfall coming down. And then I'm gonna want, we're gonna put another pool. This kind of coming down like this. And I'm just going to add some more of that phthalo blue just because I want to really, I want that to be. And then I'm going to put some rocks or something here to block this off. All right. Now I'll go back with some white and dark in here. Just adding a little bit of highlights on. Just make some foam. Just gonna wipe some of this off because I like how the foam ended up on the bottom. So Just gonna pull some of that blue down. Alright, so let's put a little bit of landmass back here. And this is just some Van Dyke Brown, just alright, let me get my palette knife and let's start getting some rocks. All right, so I'm gonna mix some black, some of my blue, some of my green, and the Van Dyke Brown, and we're just gonna make just a nasty dark color. All right, so let's say we've got I want them a little bit jagged. And then we're gonna have this rock coming out underneath. Going to add a little bit more black to this. And then we're going to highlight that. So let me and you don't want to cover all of the dark off. You just want to just kind of let the knife just a little bit more dark right in. All right, just getting some different variations on here. And let me wipe this knife off and I'm gonna make that a little bit different of a color. Crap on a cracker, not a big deal. Let me just take a brush and and then I think we're gonna have some bushes here. All right, so I'm gonna make, all right, let's take some more of our mixture here. I'm gonna mix a little bit of blue in with that. And then I'm gonna have some flowers hanging down off this one, I think. Thank you. Alright. And we're gonna stop that one. So let's go back in with, I'm going to clean my my 1-inch brush here. And we're going to go in to our yellow again. And I'm just letting it get darker as we go down. So that's just like another tree in there. Let me wipe that off. And let me see, I'm going to take this brush. I'm going to add a little bit more of the sap green. That kind of looks good. Let's put a little bit on this side, a little bit of that blue. All right, wash these two brushes off. Thank you. going to, I'm going to take my small 2-inch brush and I'm going to go into the sap green. And we're going to put a tree going right through here. Going to mix a little bit of black in with that green and darken that up. All right. And I'm going to add some more cad yellow. And I'm going to put a little bit of thinner on my brush so that I can get that yellow to stick onto that green. Lighten that up a little bit more. So we're going to go in with some white. I just want that to really stand out. There we go. Got something coming off the canvas over here. We don't know what that is, but all right. So let me take my knife and one of my rock colors. Thinner. give the illusion that there is some sort of ground up there. Well, I'm putting a rock right in there. I wasn't gonna have a rock there, but I guess we're gonna now. And I'll have to come back and fix that. Needed to put some shadows under these rocks anyways, so all right. get some more white. So you can go in with some straight white. First, I'm going to smooth my top here. All right, let me go in with some white. I'm gonna thin it down. All right. just have to go in and define those rocks again. We got the dark and Okay. Let me take, let's see. I'm gonna add a little bit of cadmium red. Fan brush and see if I can make it look like there's some little flowers or something. Let's see, I'll try it over here. That brush. All right, let me try this. Let's see, I need a little bit more dark under some of these rocks. I'm going to take some black and use this knife right here. coming down. Come on. Mr. Zeus is coming down. All right, Mama's got 10 minutes and then I gotta go up and start supper there. All right, so. All right, I gotta do something different here. I'm not liking my water. Make it, bud. You gonna make it? All right, I need some liquid white for there. Thank you. right. Clean this brush. Not just splashing up there. All right, so let's need to make some darker. All right, now let me take the liquid white into the yellow. All right, now I put some rocks in. So what color am I gonna use? All right, let's put a little bit burnt umber. All right. that dark color. Take the brown. Alright, we need a smaller fit over it. All right, here we go. this. We are going to call this one done. I'm going to put some water lines in. gonna call this one done. All right. I'm gonna call that.